It is wonderful coming again to you through this social medium, YouTube, and to all other media, that these video clips shall be forwarded to in the future. So I want to say you are welcome to this channel where we try to speak on the gospel. Today I want to speak on, for how long will you be indecisive? For how long will you be indecisive? For how long will you be indecisive? This is taken from the book of 1 Kings chapter 18 and verse number 21. 1 Kings 18, 21. And Elijah came unto all the people and said, how long ought ye between two opinions? If the Lord is God, follow him. But if Baal, follow him. And the people answered him not a word. And the people answered him not a word. Prophet Elijah, for those who don't know the antecedent, the story that preceded this verse, maybe I should try and update you, bring you up to speed. I'm speaking on how long will you be indecisive. This, the people of Israel have heard, they have started to worship Baal and gods which God Yahweh did not sanction. Those gods were essentially imported to the country by Jezebel. Jezebel, because Ahab married a prophetess of Baal, who was Jezebel, he imported the religion from her country to the land of Israel. And the people started worshipping Baal. Intriguingly, when this continued, God has been speaking with his prophet Elijah of what the people were doing, and other prophets in the land, that what Ahab was doing was wrong, that he, God, did not sanction what he was doing. But the prophets have been cold, they have been cornered, they were handcuffed, and many of them could not confront King Ahab. However, at a particular juncture, God, having dined and wine with prophet Elijah, instructed him to go to the palace and tell the king that he will withdraw rain from coming to the world. There shall be no rain. Rains shall cease for certain number of years. He said 3.5 years. And after delivering the message, he left according to the instruction of Yahweh, to where God instructed him to go to. The people suffered for this period of years. No rain, drought everywhere. And after it all, the people ought to have seen God's handwriting in what was happening, but they didn't. Instead, they keep on obeying Baal, the imported god, and other gods, small gods imported into the country. They started obeying, continue obeying, and dissociated themselves from Yahweh. They distanced themselves from Yahweh. So, God, being a merciful God, after that length of years, sent again his servant, prophet Elijah, that he should go and show himself unto the king who has been searching for him for years. And when he showed himself unto the king, he asked the king to gather the prophets of Baal together, and they meet at Carmel. There he was now speaking unto them that despite what God did, the people of Israel were still recalcitrant. They were unchanging. They were one leg in, one leg out. They do not know whether they should indeed continue to worship Yahweh or continue to worship Baal and other small gods imported into the country. This, they were indecisive. This indecisiveness essentially stemmed out of the miracles that those small gods were doing, because those small gods were also performing exploits. Therefore, the people were thinking that, will God even perform better? God could not have performed better than what these small gods were performing. So, this made them indecisive. And that was why the prophet said here in the book of 1 Kings chapter 18 verse 21 that, for how long will they be indecisive? For how long will they juggle between small gods and God and Yahweh? For how long will they continue in that position? They continued in that position because of the small miracles they were seeing that the gods doing for them. And they consider the drought for 3.5 years to be circumstantial. They do not see anything special there. It could have happened. Climate change. They attached the drought to climate change, just as we attach so many other things happening in the world today to climatic change. It is because of climate change. We do not see ourselves, we do not see our sins to have handcuffed God in sending miracles and delivering us. But it could see climate change. We could read into it. And therefore we say it is climate change. Some people, because they have studied climatology, and others will say there is no God's involvement in what is happening in the world. It is simply circumstantial. Some will forecast, statistical forecast, climatic statistical forecast, that at every 10 years, or 20 years, or 50 years, and so on and so forth, something like this will happen. And since their predictions have been, in quote, accurate, they cannot see nor reason that God's involvement in human's affair. Therefore, their mind become obstinate. They do not want to change unto God. This is like what happened in the ancient days, what happened during the days of Elijah. And the people saw climate change, a circumstantial phenomenon. Therefore, they say, no way. We rather continue to worship this Baal, the Baals we have known to be supplying our needs, providing for us, making miracles for us. This Yahweh that you are talking about cannot perform better. He could not do extraordinary feats than this. They remain stagnant and unyielding. So the prophet said, for how long did they continue in their position of indecisiveness? For how long will they just between the real God and the false gods? This again message is coming to you out there. For how long will you continue in the position of your indecisiveness? You have been hearing the gospel for how long? But because you have earned for yourself a social status by your hard work, you have earned for yourself several degrees, and you can project so many things into the future which accurately come to pass, and in your field, maybe scientific field, biology field, and so on and so forth, you have been acclaimed to be the best. You have been acclaimed to be accurate. You are professor emeritus. And therefore, you consider it unreasonable to think that there is a God anywhere at all. This message again is coming to you. How long will you continue in your indecisiveness? For how long will you continue in that position? Think about a student in an exam hall who is doing an objective exam. No, when you are doing objective exam, the answers look very similar. Sometimes it may be an apostrophe that will separate the answers. And if a student has not mastered that aspect very well, he will be confused. And he will be thinking between the two options, that is it this or that. Meanwhile, the time is going. No thanks to coronavirus, which has made computer-based tests a global phenomenon now. Almost all schools, test institutions of higher learning, even secondary schools or high schools, are concentrating on computer-based tests now. Now, what do I want to infer? What I'm trying to say is, in computer-based tests, the answers will be similar. You will see it, slight changes. Or maybe some students in a quiz, and the time is going, they will give you maybe 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 15 seconds, 30 seconds to answer a question. And the answer will be very, very similar. Apostrophe alone separates the correct answer from the wrong. Then you will be thinking, is this this, is that that? If that person, the student, has failed to master that aspect very well, and his mind is indecisive, which one should I take? Is it A or B or A or B, B or A? As the student continues in this position, the time will lapse. And we hear the bell, or the question, in computer-based question in some cases, we roll away, giving him or another question to answer. And maybe that question is 1 mark. It means he has lost the mark. She has lost it. Now, that is how indecisiveness is. That is now indecisiveness is in the world. I've made an illustration of what indecisiveness is to students. Some people, in the aspect of marriage, they will be indecisive because the person and mind has been focusing on getting married to since a teenage year. Two persons approach her. They all look alike. Both persons possess the characteristics she has been praying for all along. And they seem at par. But something will be in a person that will make him or extraordinary. And as long as she continues in a position of indecisiveness, she may eventually lose both of them because she has failed to decide and decide at the right time. And maybe those guys at the time who have come of age and cannot wait any further, they progress and go to another person, thereby making her lose the two options. And subsequent options that will come to her will be the one that she has never prayed for at all. In the case like this, you can see what indecisiveness can cause. Indecisiveness can make someone lose, just as I made that illustration. Consider another illustration. Now, consider a person who is into forest trade. Sometimes I try to know how to do this forest trade business, but I have not been able to master it very well. Now, someone into forest trade, and you will see the curve going on like this, like that, like that. You will not know, maybe you should buy or you should hurt yourself from buying. And as you linger, the thing will keep changing. And lo and behold, it may spike up or fall. Then you have a whole lot of time again to wait because you have not decided right at the appropriate time. You have failed to take the decision when it matters most. Now, the prophet is saying to the people, and I am also saying to you, viewers and listeners out there, that for how long will you be indecisive? For how long will you be indecisive? You have been hearing the matter of salvation for long, yet you have not decided. For how long will you continue in that position? You continue in the position further, you will lose. Just like those people who fail to decide, like a student who fail to decide at the right time loses. Like a spinster or a bachelor who fails to decide at the right time loses. Like a businessman, a forest man, who fails to decide at the right time loses. And was thinking, maybe the prices of material will still be lowered. So he failed to stock his goods. And then, lo and behold, the next time he saw his prices spiking up, then he started losing, has himself to blame. While those who have stocked the material, they started reaping in reward. For how long will you be or continue in your position of indecisiveness? God wants you. God, through me, is speaking to you today that you should decide for whom you want to belong to. You should decide now for whom you shall belong to. And as Prophet Moses counseled the people, I want to counsel you again that you must decide for Christ. You must decide for Christ. Yes, God has given every human on earth level playing ground in academics, the books, unbeliever studies, those who do not believe Christ, is the same book that those who believe Christ studies. Therefore, it is a level God give us, because God sent rain on us, God sent sun on us, giving us level playing ground. to operate business in the world, to study, to do science, to do researches, and so on and so forth. Yes, those who have not given their lives to Christ may be making advancements. While you think you are not making advancements, and you have thought of what necessity, of what importance, of what benefit is it to you giving your life to Christ. I want to tell you that you have great benefit. There is great reward for you if you give your life to Christ. And that is why you must decide for Christ today. You must stop being indecisive. I strongly counsel you. I strongly advise you to give your life to Christ. Do not be one leg in, one leg out. Do not waver between two options again. The genuine and the real option is Christ Jesus. Because Christ Jesus will give you endless joy. He gives you peace that transcends all human understanding. The Bible says, Jesus said, "My peace I give unto you, not as the world gives." The peace of God that Jesus will give you, no money can buy it. The peace is extraordinary. The peace he will give you, you cannot explain. And many of the things we are searching and looking for and running, pursuing in the world is peace, joy. And this, God promises to give you if you can give your life to Him. It is time for you to give your life to Him. Consider this message and give your life to Him. If you give your life to Him, He will prove Himself strong and mighty on your behalf. On your behalf. Measuring salvation by material possessions in the world, that is not the standard of God for measuring salvation. It is people who have coined that standard. Some preachers have coined that standard, that it is when sister or brother so and so could make it academically, that is when we are sure he is a believer. It is when XYZ can make it in his or her business, that is when we know he or she is a believer. It is when ABC could prosper as a preacher, that is when we know he is really serving God. That is not the standard of God for measuring salvation. The standard of God for measuring salvation is not by material things of the world. The devil has entered into those pictures to bring oppression into the Christian fold. When they started measuring the standard of salvation by how successful a man is, or by how easy a sister could get a spouse, whereas another sister has been praying for 20, 30 years, yet he has no proposal. When we started measuring, when the devil entered into those pictures to started praying, leading prayers like that, and started preaching like that, that it is by that that salvation can be measured, depression enters, and so many other negative things started happening in Christian folk. That is not what the early believers used in measuring salvation. The early believers never used money. Check the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 5, and the like. Chapter 8, they said, Simon said unto Peter, that I want to also have this Holy Spirit. And he offered him money. And Peter said, to hell with you and your money. because he never measured salvation by material things, by money, by things we can see. But he measured salvation by how fearful a man is when he or she hears the word of God. The Bible says that this is the person I respect and the person who trembles when he or she hears the word of God. When he or she hears God's word, that this word is speaking to me, she trembles. He trembles, bow down, and repents. That is the standard of God for measuring salvation. Not by all those materialistic things. Yes, it is good. If there is no money, I will not get this laptop. If there is no money, I will not get data to launch this to the world. But that is not the yardstick for measuring salvation. And we should cease from using that as the yardstick for measuring salvation. We should cease from causing havoc in the minds of believers, making them to die untimely death. And though some of them will get to heaven, but God does not want it. And we should stop all those nonsensical preachings based on materialistic things. Now, what I'm saying is, you should stop being indecisive and decide for Christ now. Your position does not mean you are saved. Until you repent genuinely, confess your sins, and ask God to come into your heart, and you will determine in your heart that you will never go back into that sin again, that is when you are saved. And by that, you will continue to read your Bible. You will continue to pray unto Him. For now, you are His child. John chapter 1 says that all those who believe Him, He has given power to be called and become children of God. When you have repented of your sins, confessed your sins, and forsake those sins, and you have given your heart to Christ Jesus, and you have asked Him to come into your heart, dwelling there, directing your paths, then you are saved. And you continue to read your Bible. You continue to pray to Him, just like your son. And if you are yet to have a son, for any reasons whatsoever, yet to be married, or you are still single, you are yet to have a son. You have somebody looking up to you. And the person who is looking up to you will not be tired in calling you. And my sister, I need 10 naira or $1 to buy this in my school. I need $1 to buy that. I need $3. He will keep on asking you because he or she is looking upward to you. That is how children are to their parents. They keep on looking on their parents. And their parents will not falter nor fail to supply the needs of those children. Because if they don't supply the needs of those children, who else will? Therefore, they keep on supplying the needs of their children. That is how you are now to God. You should keep on talking to Him. He's now your Father. If you have genuinely repented of your sins, confessed those sins, and determined in your heart that you will never go back to the sins again, you are saved. And you have called Jesus into your heart to be living there, to be directing you. The Bible is the word of God. Be reading the Bible. Be meditating on it. When you open your Bible and you read, the Spirit of God will instruct you. The Bible says you will hear a word behind you that will tell you that this is the way. And that is the Spirit of God. That Spirit of God will instruct you and will tell you about what you are reading. We expand it more unto you. And of course, there are other very good Christian channels on social media and other Christian books on social media or hard copies that you can get and read read, listen to, or view, by that we'll be growing in faith. I am sincerely appealing to your conscience today that now is the acceptance time. Today is the day of salvation. Tomorrow we essentially be late because you don't know what lies ahead of you. Neither do I know what lies ahead of me a second from now. If I finish this video, I don't know what will happen next. We all pray for good things to happen. But if negative things, if negative things or things happen, what shall we do? That is why tomorrow will be late. Now is the acceptance time. Now is the day of salvation. Do not delay the day of salvation again. Do not tarry. Do not hesitate. Do not falter. Do not waver in deciding for Christ, as the people have wavered before. Now is the salvation time. Today is the day of salvation. Till when I come your way again, may the Lord bless your heart as you decide for Christ in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you till I come your way again. Have a wonderful time.